Hello everybody, today's video is about a pressure drop in pipeline systems. Pipes are used to transport all kinds of fluids. Examples can be found in the transport of crude oil or natural gas in large pipelines. But also at home, tap water is transported through pipes. If you visit an industrial site where bulk chemicals are produced, you see complex systems of pipes and equipment. The systems consist of many different elements, such as straight pipes, vertical pipes, horizontal pipes, valves, bands, etc. To design such systems, it is important that we know how much energy is lost during the transport of fluids through all kinds of devices. To illustrate how you can tackle this problem, we look at simple systems and learn you how to calculate the pressure loss over such a system. We illustrate this with some theory and an example. In a previous video, we have seen that the pressure drop over a straight pipe can be obtained from the Fanning equation. In this equation, F is the friction factor, which is dependent on the Reynolds number, L the length of the pipe, D the diameter, rho the density of the fluid, and V the place and time average velocity in the tube. Now we can combine this equation with the mechanical energy balance. Refresh your memory a little bit. How did the mechanical energy balance look like? Under steady state conditions, this balance becomes. The last term of this equation represents the amount of mechanical energy which is converted into thermal energy. If we consider the flow through a horizontal straight pipe with a constant mass flow rate and assume that work on the system can be neglected, the combination of this equation and the Fanning equation results in EFR, which represents the amount of energy per kilogram of the fluid which is dissipated in the straight tube by friction with the wall. If you look at the units, you will see immediately that we have joules per kilogram. Until now, we only talked about straight pipes and not over pipeline systems with bends, valves and so on. All these types of obstacles will lead to situations where extra energy is dissipated. In turbulent flows, this can be easily modeled using an expression for the energy dissipation per unit of mass, EL, that is similar to the one obtained from the Fanning equation and the mechanical energy balance. The velocity V in this equation refers to the downstream velocity, and KL is the loss coefficient of the bend, valves or other obstruction in the flow. If the flow is turbulent, the value of KL is constant, and the values can be found in tables. For example, for the 90 degrees bend with a sharp angle, KL has a value of about 1.3, and an open valve has a value of KL of about 0.2. And if the valve is half closed, the value is about 6. In general, the total energy dissipation is the sum of the wall friction in all straight pipes and of the energy dissipation in all other fittings. So the total energy dissipation per unit of mass can be calculated from the sum of the different contributions. Let's illustrate this result by applying it to an example of a simple pipe system. From an open basin, water flows by gravity in an open tank. As illustrated, the pipeline system contains of two sharp 60 degrees bends and a valve for controlling the flow rate. We could ask, what's the flow rate when the valve is half closed? To answer this question, we need extra information about the length, the diameter, pipe roughness and height of the basin and the values of the loss coefficients of the bends, valves and the entrance and the exit of the pipe. As you can see, the highest value of KL is the half closed valve. From the steady state mechanical energy balance between point 1 and 2, you can derive the energy dissipation of this pipeline system. Realize that the velocity in point 1 and in point 2 are both very small and that the local pressures are both atmospheric. Further, no work is performed by a pump. the total energy dissipation now becomes, combining this equation with, gives an expression for the velocity. The value of the average velocity can be obtained by iteration, because the friction factor F also depends on the velocity. The resulting value of the velocity, the friction factor for a rough pipe and the volume flow rate can now be obtained. The velocity V is equal to 2.1 meters per second and the friction factor F is 0.0875 and the volume flow rate is 16.5 liters per second. Do you already feel yourself an engineer who can design a pipeline? You will see that it is not too difficult, but be aware that you take all the parts of the system into account. Thanks for your attention.